Like, can you imagine having a moment like that, doing a Judd Apatow film and going back to your day job, thinking that you're stuck? The next day, I could not stop thinking about that. I was like, well, maybe, I know I'm playing it safe, but maybe it's time for this college kid to turn pro. You know what I mean? Maybe I gotta fucking, I gotta rethink my life. Maybe I got, maybe this is a time for me to pursue acting full time. But you know, look at me. I know I look like a fucking double chinned Asian Mr. Burns with bad posture. But I don't know. I mean, maybe this is time for me. Maybe this is a sign. By the way, I'm thinking all this while 50 patients are waiting for me. Not a good look. And my nurse is desperately trying to get me to focus. She goes, Dr. Jeong, you have a patient in room 2 waiting for you. I was like, well, nurse, you have a doctor who doesn't give a fuck. Just did a movie, Carol. Just did a movie, man. You don't get it. And believe it or not, I quit my day job the next day. True story. Oh, I was scared, man. I was fucking scared because I didn't have any family support. Like, my strict traditional Korean dad who wanted me to be a doctor before I was born, no, he was severely bumping on this shit, dude. He was just like, he cursing me out in Korean, you pinanum sekia, you bring great shame to Jeong family. And then after the hangover, we are so proud. I knew you'd make it, boy. I knew you'd make it. I believe in you. We are so proud of your tiny ding-dong. So proud. The smaller the penis, the bigger the box office. Oh, thanks, Papa. Great phrase. Okay.